In today's lecture, we will take up two issues. First is management versus administration, and second is management versus leadership. Although using the term versus may not be a good word, because you know versus means essentially these two, the two side of versus, they are warring factions, and they are more like fighting with one another, which is not true. So first of all, I would like to tell you how management and administration debate is viewed in India. By and large, in India, administration is closely associated with government functionaries and their activities. For example, you say that the administration of this state is very loose. The administration of this state is very tight administration. Tight, mind you. What is meant by tight? That means the law and order situation is under control. Some people say that the administration of New Delhi Municipal Corporation, NDMC, is very good. But the administration of municipal corporations, other three municipal corporations, is not very good. So administration has come to be associated with anything which is related to government. So at the apex level, there is union government and its administration. So how is the Ministry of Agriculture behaving? Is it looking after the agricultural sector well? How is the Ministry of Corporate Affairs functioning? Has it been able to ensure that India's ranking goes up in the ease of doing business? How is the law ministry holding up? Is it has it brought about some good acts in the parliament? So something like that. Similarly, you say that how is the state government functioning? How is the state administration functioning? How is the revenue department functioning? At district level, you say, how is the district administration functioning? Are they able to achieve the revenue targets, or the district is crime free? At the block level, again, same parameters. At the village level, at the panchayat level, the administration of this village panchayat is very poor, people say. So anything which is associated with government is what is called administration. The top guys, they are the top administrators, and then you know they have people under them who carry out tasks or activities as per their directive. So this is meant by administration. Management is generally associated with corporate bodies, management of a company, even public sector undertakings. How is the management of NTPC? How is the management of Coal India Limited? These are all public sector enterprises. How is the management of Hindustan Zinc after it was this year compared to last year? Okay. What is the performance of that hotel which was earlier under the government sector and now it is privatized? So management's, if the hotel has done better, we say the after the change of ownership, the management has performed better. But you also hear this word administration in corporate bodies. There is an admin department. For example, if you work for a large BPO company, you will find it is the admin department which is responsible to pick you from a particular point and ferry you up to the office, and after the office hour, drop you back to the same point. It is arranging the transportation. So that department is called administration department. So within the corporate body, administration department looks after building and facilities management, functions like transportation or liaison with the agencies that provide utility service. So if one particular phase which services your office is under repair, So you go to the admin guy, why the electricity, why we are not receiving the grid power, why are we resorting to the generator power, generator set power. So within the corporate body, administration means that part of the company which looks after things like water, transportation, conservancy services, which means cleanliness of the building, upkeep of the building, upkeep of the facilities, that is called administration. So this is the view in India. But traditionally, there are two views of management versus administration. There is a British view and there is an American view. But I thought I should give you the Indian view, how we view day-to-day administration. For example, in our own college, when we say management, we talk about director, the director general, or the vice chairman, senior people. They are the management. And when we call of administration, we think, talk about those people who are engaged in the provision of security, payment of electricity bill, upkeep of the building, cleanliness and hygiene, maintaining cleanliness and hygiene in the building, ensuring that all the property tax and all electricity bills are paid on time. This department we call as administrative department. So this is the Indian perspective. Now we will take the classical perspectives as explained by Professor Praveen Duraiswamy. So if a question is asked in the examination, and if it comes, it's a question of 15 marks, what are the differences between administration and management? You have to explain to them, as I explained to you in the previous slide, as to what it is known in India, that administration is normally associated with government and management is normally associated with the corporate bodies. And within corporate bodies, what is normally referred to as administration. But classically, as far as classical definition is concerned, Professor Praveen has given very good distinction, if 8 or 9 sets of distinctive features between administration and management. So first is that administration is basically a determinative process. Determinative function means it is predominantly, it involves decision-making activities. Administration is decision-making activity. Management, as we know, manage. You have to manage things, people say. Manage things. So management mainly is an executive function, as it is largely concerned with implementation of decisions made by the administration. So, administration has taken a decision that everybody who goes out during pandemic must wear a face mask, must wear a mask, and social distance has to be maintained. This is an administrative decision. Management decision is how to implement this order. Who will implement this order? And if administration has said, if people are found loitering around and not maintaining social distance without a mask, what will be the fine? So management has to ensure that how to, what mechanism to adopt so that people follow the government rules, which are in the interest of the people. And if they do not, penalties are levied on them. How to manage that is the management decision. So scope of administration number two is wider, as it governs the entire system, that is whole organization. So scope of management is comparatively limited to a subsystem, let us say a function or a department. So at Delhi administration has said that students can attend school, those who are in class 12th or 10th, but it should be ensured that at any given point in time, only 1/3 of the class strength attends the class on a particular day. So management of the school will then, you know, so it is limited. Management of the school will ensure, so they will call, suppose there are 100 students in a class in a particular school, so they will call 30 students on day 1, 30 students in day 2, and 30 students of day 3. So scope of administration is wider. It has said, given the broad guidelines and the administration, it will now, so each school administration will manage its affairs. So school management, this, okay, so Delhi government is administration and school management. Third is that objective formulation and policy formulation are the top priorities of administration. Objective formulation, policy formulation. Whereas fulfillment of these objectives and plans within the policy framework, this is the priority of the management. So objectives and policies are made by administration, and management has to ensure that these objectives are fulfilled and plans are followed. Administration usually is a top level activity in an organization, and it remains above management. Top level activity above management. Management is generally a middle level or a supervisory level activity, and it is, in hierarchy terms, it is above the non-managerial employees. So a natural corollary of all this is that what are the functions of essential functions of administration? Planning and organizing. Planning and organizing are the main functions of administrations. So what are the functions of management? Employee control, motivation, implementation. Employee control, motivation, discipline maintenance, control mechanism. This is the main function of management. So five functions we have enumerated. Some more functions I will cover in the next slide. So the sixth difference between administration and management is, because of the top level activities which administration is involved in and management is involved in, carrying out the decisions or the policies to ensure objectives of administrations are achieved. So they need different conception, they need different skills, conceptual skills. You remember the skills which are required for successful managers. Conceptual skills are needed in great amount for successful administration. Conceptual skills means skill to analyze, to be able to solve the problem, to be able to view various alternatives, to make strategic plan, to take into account seemingly unrelated departments, seemingly unrelated activities, to take a holistic view of an organization, of a business, of a perspective, and to write down a strategic plan for that organization. This requires conceptual skills. On the other hand, management is implementing of those decisions. So you require technical skills. Technical skills. Day-to-day problem solving, diagnostic skills. People skills, very important in management. Because management, as it means, you have to get the things done enthusiastically by others for achievement of a common goal. So such soft skills are very important. Technical skills are very important. Seventh point is that people in administration, they consist of people who act on behalf of the capital holders or the owners of the enterprise. Usually, management, on the other hand, consists of professionals in their area of operation, and they are employed by the organization. So typically, administrators in administration, you will find people who also own the business or who report directly to them. Management, middle level management, supervisory management consists of professionals. Eighth point is that administrative activities are largely influenced by external factors like government policies and guidelines, social and economic developments, industry-wide developments, market trends. So On the other hand, management activities are largely influenced by internal factors like organizational environment and climate and culture and targets and supplier situation, something like that. So strategic decision is the government going to give huge incentives on solar powered vehicles and do fossil fuel have still a future? Would it still grow at least at the rate of GDP growth in the country? All these decisions. So should we branch out? Should we work on the prototype of a electric car? Should we not work on the prototype of an electric car? Should we go for a tie-up with a company based in Italy? Or should we look forward towards tie-up with companies in Japan or in China? Administrative activities. Should a company which a large retail outlet chain, should it also diversify into an e-commerce business in a big way, or should it tie up with existing e-commerce platform? Administrative decision, top management decision. So once you have taken a decision that the company organization needs to get into e-commerce, then management will take over from there. Should it be a desktop app, or should it be just a mobile app, or who are the technology partners you would like to partner? Administrative decision influenced by external factors. Management activities are influenced by internal factors, localized factors. Last point is that administration is frequently used with non-business enterprises like educational institutes, military establishments, government organization. Management is mostly associated with business enterprises. In summation, I want to tell you students, let us not be too much engrossed in this debate. I am taking this lecture, I am covering this aspect because this is asked in the examination. Everybody has to perform his own set of duties which are assigned to that individual owing to the position that individual holds in the organization. And if administration is considered to be apex level position, then it is only the managers who gradually go up through the ranks and they come and occupy the top positions. But here I have explained to you administration versus management. We will now try to see the debate between leadership and management. It's an interesting debate. This debate about leader versus managers and leadership versus managers, leadership versus management, it's an eternal debate. It has never ended, nor will it ever end. I can guarantee you that. Some people say that it is necessary for a good leader to be a good manager, but it is not necessary that a good manager has to be a leader. Some people say there can be no manager without leadership qualities. People say all kinds of things. You ask me my personal view. Managing a team or management is not possible without some degree of leadership. And leadership is not possible without some degree of management. Do you agree with me? Leadership and management are separate, but they are not anathema of one another. They are not one another's antonyms. They go hand in hand. Yes, the objectives of leadership and management may be different, but they are in the same direction. they are in the same direction. It is not that leadership wants to go to North Pole and management wants to go to South Pole. It never happens. But their approach is different. So, Prime Minister Narendra Modi is an excellent leader, they say. And he has excellent PM office under him, which manages all the information for him very well. He has a very good team of bureaucrats. So, Rajnath Singh Ji may be very good defense minister as a leader. And he has excellent people working in the ministry under him who are managing. Leadership provides vision and management provides result. This is Dr. Sudhir Bis's view. Leadership provides vision and management provides result. Leadership provides mission and vision both. And management provides result, timely results. This picture which I have shown, I have taken it from a website called lifehack.org. I am very grateful to them. They have summed up leadership versus management very well. If you see, there are two circles and there is an overlap in this circle. That overlap is that both of them want to accomplish a goal. Both of them want to mobilize resource. Both of them want to explain the vision or actualize the vision. But approaches are different. Leadership focuses on goal. Management focuses on task. What does it mean? That we have to reach the goal of doubling the farmer's income. That is leadership. Management is, what steps do we take? Do we give them more subsidy? Do we give them more direct benefit transfers? Focus on task is management. Focus on goals, focus on task. Approach of leadership is sell it. Approach of management is tell it. Leadership wants to proactively sell an idea. Management wants to explain that idea further. Some of the elements in this chart may be slightly superfluous, but don't mind. By and large, third point is very pertinent. Leadership take risks. Management minimizes risks. Take risk. Let us enter into this area. Once having decided to enter into this area, let us build a management plan in which risks are minimized. Leadership encourages. It does not discourage, it encourages. Management instructs. Leadership goes against the grain. They can take a view, the stock market is going down. Let us pick good shares. It goes against the grain. Management generally tries to go with the flow. Once again, both are not in opposition to one another. Management motivates people. Leadership motivates the people. Does not mean that management demotivates them, but they generally approve or instruct. It is said management breaks the rules. Iconoclast. Image breaker. Leadership breaks the rule. Management follows the rule which are set by the leadership. So break the rule is to be viewed in a constructive manner. Break the traditional mold and set out on a new path. When the entire world, business world, was saying that there is too much competition in telecommunication business, Mukesh Ambani said, "I want to launch Jio." People thought the guy is crazy. Airtel is struggling, Vodafone is struggling, Aircel is struggling, Arcom is struggling, MTNL is struggling, BSNL has gone bonkers, and he wants to start with a 4G platform. So he broke the rule. In a turbulent market, he says, the market is turbulent, that means there will be a shakeout. Can I expedite that shakeout and make a carve a space for myself? Break the rules. Management follows the rules which are set by the leadership. Leadership inspires trust. When late Dhirubhai Ambani said, "Do you want to become the biggest company in India?" he was inspiring trust. He broad-based the shareholding pattern of Reliance, of any big company. He told people that, "Invest in my company. I will give you returns either by way of enhanced share value or by way of dividend." And he said, "I put my own money into it. I will remain loyal. I will remain faithful to my shareholders." So he held an annual general meeting in a stadium. Normally, annual general meetings are a hush-hush affair. People don't want very many shareholders to come. But he held it in a stadium. He invited people. Asked them questions. Gave them gifts. Inspired trust. And Reliance shareholders, they invested in Reliance. And they have become, people have become rich by holding on to the share of Reliance. How many rights issue Reliance has given? How many bonus issues Reliance has given? On the other hand, management, it is not that management does not want to inspire trust, but it expects control. It wants to control the hierarchy. Because if people go haywire, there will be indiscipline. So they operate in different spheres. Leadership fosters ideas. Management, it assigns tasks. So this is a very good pictorial diagram. I could not understand what is meant by sell it and tell it, but otherwise, focus on goals, focus on task, take risks, minimize risk, encourage, instruct, go against the grain, go with the flow. Beautiful explanation. Go with the flow. So management will say that if everybody is trying to diversify market, if everybody is entering the African market of telecommunications, let us enter that market. Leadership may say, if everybody is going there, will this market become crowded again? Should I go? Should I enter into African market? Or should I traditionally go to that market? Let me go to Latin American market. Tech Mahindra, instead of concentrating in Africa, everybody was concerned, it went to Latin America. It went to Turkey to execute projects. Blue Ocean strategy. What is Blue Ocean strategy? That you operate in a space where the competition is less. Blue Ocean. Otherwise, ocean is red. Big fish is eating small fish. There is a fierce fighting going on and blood is spilling all over. So this is the difference between leadership versus management. I will show you another pictorial difference between leadership and management in the next slide. And that I have taken from harvardbusinessreview.org. Very interesting. This is another very good pictorial representation of difference between managers and leaders. Once again, I don't like management, managers versus leaders thing. Management and leaders, which is what I want. But this is how people ask questions. It makes the debate interesting, right? Where you have two sides, you know. So I view managers and leaders as somebody like a strategist and an achiever. Both of them are required, strategist and an achiever, or a leader and a manager. That is how I view it. But this is interesting. First, on the left, it is subject which is written, and there are various subjects. And what is the perspective of managers and what is the perspective of leaders? So the role makeup, the role of a manager is to provide stability to an organization? Stability. Stability with growth. Leaders are required for change. When a change is required, leaders are required. So, sir, are you saying that a new manager or a new leader will be required for change? There are some managers who are very good leaders. They can provide the change. So, if there is a CEO who is an excellent leader, he has got the vision, he has got the people skill, he has got the strategic skill, he has got the conceptual skills. So, he can be one manager and leader can be one person, of course. Of course, manager and leader can be one person. And I said, most managers have some degree of leadership in them. And most leaders have some degree of managerial skill with them. They have to have. So, make up managers, but essentially managers, especially middle managers, they are there to provide stability with some growth. Leaders are for change. So, it's only a leader who can provide, who can dismantle the previous tax regime and take India onto goods and services tax. One tax, one nation, GST. Because stability, everybody likes stability. Everybody likes status quo. The problems which are have, see the Kisan, the farm movement, farm laws, three farm laws, three farm acts. One which talks about breaking the stranglehold of APMC mandis, and which talks about contract farming, and one which talks about not having any restrictions for storage, three farm laws. It has created instability. But without instability, there cannot be a change. So leadership, anybody with leadership skills is not afraid of change. He is not afraid to challenge the status quo. When it comes to decision making, leaders facilitate decision making. They don't announce decisions. They don't force decisions. Managers have to take a decisive action. They take a decision. They make a decision. They announce a decision. Approach is managers, their plans are detailed around constraints. So they will typically do a SWOT analysis and, you know, they will come out with what are the constraints, how to overcome the constraint. This is the approach to business. Whereas leadership, they lead and they show the direction. So one's approach is conservative, manager's approach is conservative, leader's approach is proactive, bold. Vision of manager is short term. But vision of leader, this is a very essential difference, is long term horizon. So typically leaders talk about where do they want to see their organization in 10 years. So when the chairman of ITC, the IIT trained and Harvard educated, was he Harvard educated? Yogesh Deveshwar. He said, when he took over as chairman and managing director of ITC, he wanted that his company ITC should have more than 50% of revenue coming from non-tobacco products. He did not think of short term. He achieved that by putting in greater efforts into the business of hoteliering and in the business of paper craft and stationery, in the business of food products. Many of the brands have become thousand crore plus brands, Ashirwad Atta. So long-term horizon. In terms of control, managers, they exhibit formal influence. So production manager will exhibit influence on the factory. But leaders, they control by their personal charm, by their charisma. they are not able to control or win over only those people who report to them. To give you an example, if there is a factory manager and he is able to control all the people of his factory, it is inherent that he will be able to, it is obvious because he exercises formal influence and formal control over factory people. But suppose he is also able to influence control over sales team. So if the factory is facing a problem and he is able to tell the sales team as to which products they should push more, which products they should push less, and he's able to sell his idea proactively to people who are outside his sphere of control, that factory manager is a leader. So typically leaders, they appeal to the heart. Managers appeal to the head. When it comes to an organizational culture, the manager, they endorse that culture. Once a culture has been set, they endorse that culture. But leaders shape that culture. If leaders want to change, if you want to change the organizational culture, then managers cannot change. Managerial skills of planning, organizing, staffing, it cannot. You require a leader to shape the culture. It is said in terms of action, managers take reactive actions. Leaders take proactive action. What is proactive action? Proactive action means to study things in advance and to plan for it and to take prior action so that whatever the change is, it impacts you positively, not negatively. Now, you know, this chart or this diagram which has been given by the author, some of it may be a bit superfluous. Some of it may appear verbose, some of it may appear repetitive, but we have to understand the gist of it. It's able to explain very well. In terms of risk, managers take minimum risk. Leaders take risks. In fact, they thrive in an era of risks. Rules, managers makes rules. Leaders, they say they break the rules. You see, in the political scenario, you will find a political leader. Sometimes he would break all rules for the sake of enhancement of the party or maybe for the country. So is true for business. And I remember we had a fantastic leader called Mr. R.K. Narang in Indian Corporation. He used to say, people pehle, paper piche. That means push the paperwork. Push people in front. First, look after the people. Paperwork can follow. Breaking rules. In terms of direction, they say managers take the existing direction. They keep the status quo. Whereas leaders change the direction, change the course of the company. Managers place lot of emphasis on results which are measurable, that I have achieved this sales figure. Whereas leaders, they don't look at specific numbers. They are basically bothered or concerned about overall achievement. If these numbers have been reached, are these sustainable numbers? Have they been achieved by fair means, or they have been achieved under great pressure? Suppose you have achieved the target, sales target, but you have not been able to ensure that sales from your factory to your distributors does not result in further sales from distributors to customers. That means in the coming months your sales will suffer. So they look at achievement holistically. Very important is managers, they do the things right. But what are the right things? It is decided by a leader. Excellent. Leaders decide what is the right thing, and then managers do that thing in the right way. Isn't it very good? What is to be done will be decided by the leader. And then managers will decide how it will be done, how it will be achieved. Managers focus on managing work. Leaders focus on leading people. In terms of people they work with, in terms of human resources, it is said managers, they work with subordinates. Nowadays, nobody calls it subordinate. People call it team members. Leaders work with followers. In an organization, it is often said that when a leader leaves, many of the employees leave along with him because they are mesmerized by that leader. They believe in him. They believe that this leader is a leader who can be considered a mentor to that employee. People invariably follow leaders to the new companies. Many times when iconic leaders leave an organization, the share value of the organization goes down. So, leaders of the organization, and they are all managers, you know, they all start as managers. Nobody is born a leader. These are the qualities you develop over time. Unless, of course, you have inherited a large enterprise. But even if you have inherited a large enterprise and if you are a poor leader, you will fritter away all the advantage. Leaders also value means which are used and not just the end results. Leaders are concerned about ethics. Leaders are concerned about sustainability. Leaders don't want to achieve just for the sake of projecting a result. They want to achieve for the sense of satisfaction. They don't want to artificially paint success. They want real success to be achieved by real people, for the organization, and they want everyone to partake the fruits of success. The vision of leadership is very broad, very high. Leaders create good leaders. So, if a manager is able to inculcate leadership skills, he rises to the top. So this is my position on managers versus leaders.